right, let's dance, Blue. I'm about to bring back on the 2000s this year, man. Hold on. Okay.
Now that we got that done,
get demonetized real quick here. Take it off the internet, get banned. So, I'm working on a functional analysis of how to train somebody a practical way to use particle physics in this journal. I got the other ones. I got the Bluestone Militia. I got the Bluestone Bible, and I got the, well, that's for the Masons, a lot of psych game in there. I'm also playing spin direction a little bit here with the constants as a key for not knowing, again, a lot of Fermilab stuff, of condensation of particle position, the test of potential spin direction, spin measurement direction, potential spin measurement outcome. On certain keys, I'm using those like key symbols on a ball and air, ball and water. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it. Ball and air, ball and water for the key references, and so that gives you a point that you can play around with this metric of, again, the ball and air, ball and water, beaker, ball and fluoride, hydromonium acid sitting in solution for time indexes that aren't measured. For resistances of the, here I have it just as the difference of water and oil, compression to viscosity issues, heat, light, and sound, a crack in the bottom of the beaker and the dry one and watching it bounce, depending on what value you give that net force. Bring up Aristotle's common sense physics. This is a pretty heavy duty, easy to check, easy to look up, and I'm backtracking gravity. Obviously, ball and air, ball and water. By a key is something I've added to the Fermilab mix here that specifies what that mechanic does when it gives you that XYZ matrix, gives you the code ciphering bases, A plus B equals C, yeah, Y plus Z equals Y, why not, you know, on the secondary matrix for X plus, or Z plus Z plus, equals Z. For 1 plus 1, 0 plus 1 equals 1, 1 plus 1 equals 0, depending on how you took that matrix or decided to make a choice off that initial matrix, it starts to go 0 plus 0 equals 0, 0 plus 1 equals 1. Algebraically, though, this gets a little bit more complicated. I equals the negative square root of negative 1. And so we're looking at negative values here. What didn't I pay attention to in the fractal phases of pay attention to gravity, the speed of it, the distance, the timelines that they're supposed to track and follow, given those index of how functional you are about your analysis in field reports to Newtonian limits. This becomes a Newtonian limit if that matrix of describing this three-dimensional object, quick shorthand, to what will be a definition of what I have later in the key for another index above the ball and air, ball and water, is a photon, an apple, and a fission experiment with particle accelerators, right? So we're dealing with Fermilab down here, and I'm open for other designs right at this moment, but I just kind of took some pictures, and I'll be posting them up here in a minute, of this apple equation where I'm talking about the spin direction is given comparatively to the photon. I think I'm bang around and do whatever until I start to break down that equation. Can you do other things with that? Potentially. We don't know that yet. And again, the spin direction there. This apple, we're going to do the apple, FMA, not terminal velocity. We did that with the ball. Now we're moving in the Y direction on some trebuchets. I might do some graphing. I might do some small scale functioning of very tight indexes that show the simplificated ideals behind those distances and times, or, you know, some facet of that conceptual model. I could do both of them. I could do the experiment, show it once, but I gave a metrics here of, let's change the distance and see what we could find by that value before we put it into this experiment to better compound this idea of the Laplacian is greater than or equal to the zero distance of feet, because that's really what I'm looking for here, of an apple of the G matrix at the power of a number to 5 or 6 feet off the ground, with the alpha Fn equal to the F net force of apples in general. Could be the ones you have at hand, or the approximation off the average in the internet. But let's assume you can trebuchet this. When we're breaking that matrix down, how does that compound the next fractal into this next block of reorganizing those systems with those compounded values that integrate into this binary north, south, east, west kind of orientation, X, Y, and Z stuff? Like I said, I might play with CERN's Hadron Collider. I know it's a round one, but how round is it? I might need some extra space, but I think there's also another one with, like, they have double loops to feed into larger collisions. That might be an appropriate option here, but I love the photonic FMA unknown spin measurement of chasing the muon, or how collisions work, and I might give a special key under measurement to give it some value under whichever key in there I kind of determine best for how to describe the breakdown in position of that thing, because, like I said, it's all gonna be probability of it being in. They measured it, they didn't measure it. This measurement was this, but to zero it out on chemical reactions to the result that I wanted without wasting sulfuric acid in solution, or having an abundancy left over in solution to wastage, or however that thing changes the ratio. Well, you get your beakers wrong and you go to pour it all out and get your setup going for the test and it doesn't line up, because that kind of fundamental idea is it should kind of generally do some things, G1, G2, but given some of those G3 experiments, we're going to have to get pretty time dilated into multiple testing standards, where often it's not over the long haul of the experiment, but often in the beginning, where you get a lot of electron surge or electron avalanche for these calculations that come in that refine down to the most accurate tool that becomes this version of grafting that for me it was in the stone mill. Like I said, get them out there with the skid steer, hit a topology with it, oh, and then change it in winter. That's usually when you change the books, you change the test. Set there some standard of a build or engineering. You're supposed to backtrack, figure out your own artsy to it, maybe change it a little different. I don't know if it'll beat the standard model in the three ring binder yet, but as far as what this base matrix will hopefully give you some interpretation on as I build through this here, try to do one a night, kick one up, and fill out this key. You don't need to fill out every bit. As I'm saying, they build in bricks of this metrics off first, in a fun little crypto cipher that I've designed for it to work with parallel other N1 half models YF over X to generate a little energy for myself. In these field theory equations, singularities, wormhole, and things, you can Penzro your way through with some time dilating functions that help you really get through this material, get a great abundancy of vocation and experience with those terms and how to apply those terms in an FMA example, like dropping an apple or any kind of ball in solution based on what standard of law goes into those types of fields and common language differentials, regardless of the topology or mountain you're on. And the experiment will still play through, even given those Einsteinian crosses, density differences in optical Hubble lensing problems of some of this material. Because, again, in this beaker, you're going to find a lot of that lensing problem of what I'm really looking for. Experience the tests and the chemists that do this stuff physically in some experiment that really shows that loud ting crack, glass beaker, but you figure that out. I'll do it with the first kid in a steel ball bearing in the classroom, and then we'll explain why you use that a different ball for this experiment. Not that a ball in air off foot off the ground doesn't do the same effect, but the water test and the oil test make that different, especially if those are common tests that determine some of the things of the mass that backtrack x2 gravity without mixing up the dark matter equations too much in terms of their axes and systems to kind of beat that up a little bit. So yeah, we're gonna pound this out, and then like I said, probability is gonna get you a lot of grafting. A lot of grafting. That photon is there. It's there in stasis. It's in kind of form, superposition. Catch you on the next one. Get out of here.